Number 10. Serena Astorga. Serena Astorga was driving down the street in her native Salt Lake City when she became the unfortunate victim of a car collision. A Tesla crashed against a Nissan, prompting both vehicles to spiral out of control, slamming with full force against Astorga's car and three other people. Though the 50-year-old woman was the only fatal victim, five people in total had to be hospitalized and remained in critical condition, including both drivers. The Tesla owner had been speeding and ignoring traffic signals. While traveling at over 122 miles per hour, he'd run a red light before the crash occurred. Number 9. Fort Lauderdale teenagers. Three teenagers decided to take their Tesla Model S on a ride, driving at high speeds down the streets of Fort Lauderdale in Florida. They lost control of the car and the vehicle started spinning. This caused one of the 18-year-olds to be thrown out the window and land hard on the concrete. The two other teens became trapped inside the vehicle. Bystanders watched in horror as the vehicle's batteries then burst into flames. The fire was too strong and it prevented any attempts to rescue the two boys. By the time first responders arrived, it was too late. Even though a four-person specialized team had been deployed, the driver and his companion were already dead. The young man lying on the street was rushed to the hospital and his condition remains unknown as of the recording of this video. Tesla Inc. is a company founded in 2003 in Palo Alto, California. It produces electric vehicles that include several high-tech features. Since its creation, it has expanded to create solar energy products, battery energy storage, and other environmentally conscious services. Tesla prides itself on updating its car's software online, improving functionality for free. Tesla offers an autopilot feature that allows users to receive assistance while on the road. The company has stated that a human being must supervise the driving direction and emphasize that its cars are not yet autonomous. Number 8. Mike, Liam, and Quinn Coughlin. Mike Coughlin was traveling with his two young children, Liam and Quinn, aged 8 and 5, down Highway 5A in Alberta. The Tesla's autopilot system reportedly failed, and the car veered off the road and into an embankment. Coughlin died on the spot, while his children were immediately taken to the closest hospital. There, the older brother perished as well. In a desperate attempt to save Quinn's life, the doctors decided to transfer him to a children's hospital in Vancouver. Unfortunately, he too would succumb to his injuries. The family released a statement informing friends and well-wishers that his organs would be donated in the hope of saving other lives. Number 7. Incident in Nanchong, China. An unnamed 51-year-old woman in Nanchong, China, was driving her Tesla car when the auto brake reportedly failed. This led to her driving straight into oncoming traffic. She ran over several pedestrians and only came to a stop after crashing into multiple other cars. Two people died on the street and six others were rushed to the hospital. Several vehicles were badly damaged, resulting in significant repair bills. Though the exact cause of the accident wasn't officially released, alcohol and drugs were ruled out, and media outlets claimed that the car had simply gone out of control. Tesla Inc. refused to comment on the matter, and this deadly crash was just one of several involving the company during that year in the Chinese province. Though Tesla cars are sold all over the world, there are specific locations where supercharger stations are being built. As of the end of 2019, the company had installed 1,716 such stations globally. To avoid drivers leaving their cars in these spots for too long, an idle fee is applied after the batteries are fully charged. To keep their products virtually maintenance-free, Tesla produces vehicles with merely 17 moving parts, compared to the 200-plus components featured in conventional cars. That being said, Tesla has been highly criticized for failing to stick to promised release dates and for its vulnerability to hacker attacks. Number 6. Ezekiel Bishop and Ryan Briot. On Westlake Boulevard in Ventura County, California, a single car crash would claim the lives of Ezekiel Bishop and Ryan Briot. By the time the accident was reported, the Tesla sedan had burst into flames and both men were trapped inside, already unresponsive. Their bodies were eventually recovered and they were declared dead at the scene. Police speculated the crash had resulted from speeding and that the force of the impact caused the batteries to explode, leading to the fire. Little information was issued about the driver and his companion at first. After the families were notified, the names were announced. Bishop and Brio were former Oaks Christian School students, and the alumnus organized a ceremony in their honor soon after the news broke. Number 5. Unnamed driver and passenger. Two adult men whose names weren't released to the public were involved in a deadly road accident at Laguna Canyon Road. The driver and his companion traveled in a Honda Accord when a Tesla user lost control of his car, veering directly into oncoming traffic. This led to a collision that ended with the first vehicle being completely wrecked. Though the Tesla driver suffered minor injuries, the two other men died from the force of the impact. Debris was spread all across the road, which led to it being closed for most of the morning. No additional information was provided by the authorities. Up until November of 2020, 150 deaths related to Tesla cars have been documented. A report published in 2017 by the Highway Loss Data Institute concluded Tesla Model S is 50% more expensive to repair after accidents than regular cars. Model X had similar problems, being 41% more prone to crashes, and repairs were astonishingly 89% costlier than other brands. This led to insurance companies raising their primes for Tesla users. Tesla has been involved in several court cases and has been sentenced to pay different compensations as a direct result. In 2020, a court ruled that the Autopilot technology's features were not only heavily exaggerated, but it led drivers to experience a false sense of security, making accidents more likely. Autopilot mode seems prone to reckless behaviors, such as braking harshly, veering out of a lane, and even ignoring road hazards. Software problems are eerily frequent, which leads to radar failures, tailgating, and sudden speed changes. This can lead to catastrophic accidents, resulting in hospitalization and even death. Number 4. Marjorie Hill. At 9:32 a.m. in Chardon, Ohio, an 83-year-old woman driving a Subaru Forester was surprised by a Tesla Model S suddenly pulling into an intersection. Marjorie Hill wasn't wearing a seatbelt at the time of the collision and had to be rushed to the hospital via a life flight helicopter. Unfortunately, she ended up dying in the ER despite the doctor's best efforts to save her life. As of 2020, the case remains under investigation. The Tesla's driver, a 33-year-old man whose name wasn't released to the media, was wearing his seatbelt and didn't require hospitalization. Number 3. Unnamed Pennsylvanian woman. In August of 2019, a 31-year-old woman was run over by an out-of-control Tesla. She wasn't standing on the street or even driving a car, but was inside a sales office building. Her family requested her identity to be withheld from the public so they'd be able to mourn in privacy. The Tesla Model 3 driver changed lanes at the last minute in an intersection and accelerated suddenly. This prompted her to lose control. The car struck a bay to the beach office, slamming against the employee who was working at her desk. The crash victim was rushed to the hospital and remained in critical condition until she passed away from her severe injuries. Though autopilot is a useful feature, it requires the human driver to remain alert. Falling asleep at the wheel or getting distracted is to be avoided. One of the best ways to avoid an autopilot-related accident is to drive as if the system wasn't activated and rely on it only for comfort. Human supervision cannot be replaced. When used properly, the autopilot feature can be a powerful tool towards maintaining road safety. It assists drivers with speed, lane changes, parking, and even with following street signs properly. Tesla Inc. informs its users that keeping their hands on the steering wheel at all times is vital, and a reminder appears each time the feature is activated. Today's topic was inspired by Dizzy1369. If you have any other topics you'd like to learn about, subscribe and let us know in the comment section below. Number 2. James A. Accurso. Quebec-based businessman Tony Accurso had already been sentenced to 4 years in prison on charges of fraud and corruption when his son perished in a tragic car accident. James Accurso was being driven by his companion, a 38-year-old man. Both were drunk and failed to notice a sharp curve ahead. It's reported the Tesla was on autopilot, though this hasn't been confirmed by official sources. The road was completely clear, Accurso died shortly after being rushed to the hospital. The driver suffered minor injuries and was promptly released, but could subsequently be charged with reckless driving and causing the death of his passenger. Number 1. Zhao Yanying. Zhao Yanying had activated his Tesla Model S autopilot system when it crashed against a parked truck before striking a road sweeper. The accident occurred on a Chinese highway 300 miles south of Beijing. The entire sequence was recorded by a camera installed in the vehicle's rearview mirror. It shows that Tesla's driving assistance system failed to activate the brakes before or after the impact. Tesla Inc. refused to speak to the media, only releasing a statement claiming they could not retrieve any data regarding the collision. They argued that since the damage was so extensive, they had no access to the car's log data. Zhao's family sued the dealership. They claimed that the young man was led to believe the autopilot feature was completely safe and autonomous, which is why he didn't keep his eyes on the road. Thanks for watching. Would you rather drive a Tesla while blindfolded or go parachuting for the first time without an instructor? Let us know in the comments section below.